Welcome back. The arrival of outsiders changed the lives of First Nations people across the world, but many in this country, it's called an invasion. The process of colonisation remembered for decimating culture and dispossessing generations. But in the Torres Strait, first contact with the British is remembered differently. Their first encounter was with the London Missionary Society, and each year the anniversary of that meeting is celebrated with a festival called the Coming of the Light. Rachael Hocking reports.
This is the story children in the Torres Strait grow up with. The day when missionaries landed on the beaches of Erib for the first time, spreading Christianity across the Torres Strait Islands. They call it the Coming of the Light.
I'm singing about how great is God. Because of him, we are here. And because of him, we've got families, we've got friends, we got everything we want because of him.
It's a sentiment shared widely by the people of Erib, so much so that each year they celebrate the day that light came. More than 145 years ago, when France moved to expel the London Missionary Society from New Caledonia, the British Reverend Samuel McFarlane and A.W. Murray led eight Loyalty Island teachers from Lifu on a ship called Surprise. They were headed for the Torres Strait to evangelise what they called the cannibals and savages of the region. On the 1st of July 1871, they landed at Kemmos Beach on Erib or Darnley Island. Their arrival signalled the beginning of Christianity in the region, changing island life forever.
After 1871, from what I believe, that there was a lot of changes, a lot of practices, what has been in our culture has been sort of put aside, because we cannot practice this sort of thing anymore. Tribal laws, go out, raid neighbouring islands, violence, stop worship, you know, idol gods and stuff like that, you know, all these sort of things, you know, because now we accept Christianity and that's how it is.
Today those changes are hailed across the Strait, that worship also extending to one of their own, the man who accepted the missionaries all those years ago. His name was Dubbard. He was a chief of the Meriam tribe when McFarlane and Murray arrived at Kemmos Beach.
At that time, you know, there was war between neighbouring island and everything. So by having strange people come up, I'm sure there was some sort of tense at that time. But thank God, because what actually happened, Dawat Popa, for some reason, eased that tense and will 24 hours before it's actually happened.
Leslie Douglas Pitt is a direct descendant of Dubbard. Today, he's taking care of his memorial.
That's why it was my duty to look after that. I'm taking over from my grandfathers, my fathers, my uncle. Now it's my time to look after that. I'm responsible for that. It's very important because as we go into this 21st century, we seem to lose a lot of things, traditional-wise. So it's important to try to pass it on to the next generation after that. Because if we don't, that thing, it will be lost forever. Not only be present here on 1st of July every time, but all other things that are actually involved in the indigenous people.
For Leslie, keeping his Arubian culture alive is just as important as celebrating the coming of the light. When the London Missionary Society first arrived, they showed an interest in the local language and allowed for traditional drums to be used during sermons. Locals say the coming of the light brought peace to previously warring islands. But while there was change, the Arubians also fought to maintain their culture.
Space? Yeah. Okay. All right, we move down a bit.
These are traditional fish traps. They're being cared for by the next generation, kids who grow up learning both Christian and traditional values, and reaping the rewards. Travelling inland, a group of women sit and weave at the local art centre. They're making squids, turtles and jellyfish created from wire and string, keeping their culture alive and sharing it with the world. On the other side of the island, these women are using similar techniques to prepare coconut leaves for the Coming of the Light celebrations.
We come like 2-3 days before, just to keep the place clean, make it nice, look beautiful, beautify the place for the Coming of the Light.
Traditions come to life at every corner of the island, but you can't escape the impact Christianity has had on everyday life.
I think if you see in both sides the culture before Christianity, there always a belief in some a supreme being that look after, and doesn't matter who you worship, but always believe that before that time, Christianity was in the community. The kindness, the humble people that lives here, this has always been here.
July 1 prayer for you me here this morning. In the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness never hope of power.
It means so much to me because the Coming of the Light, well, it brings the light to this community, and it means so much to me.